Today, we're going to talk about classification problems in machine learning and how we can use linear programming to construct a simple classifier. Suppose you're a teacher in a math class. Your students just took the final exam. Some did very well, and some could have done a bit better. You want to understand what can predict a student's performance, so you collect some data, like the student's grade right before the exam, and the number of hours each person studied. Then you plot all of your students on this graph, and then check if they passed the exam or not. Suppose there's a student who hasn't taken the exam yet, but we know his grade and also how long he studied. Can we predict whether or not he'll pass the exam? Looking at this graph, perhaps a natural idea is to try to draw a line that separates the two classes. Then, if a student falls on one side of the line, we predict he passes. Otherwise, we predict he fails. For this specific line, our mystery student falls in the red area, so we predict that he'll fail. But there are other lines possible, and in some of them, we might predict he'll actually pass. So, given all of the lines possible, how do we find the best line? And how do we define what best even means? Actually, taking a step back, how do we even find a line that separates the two classes? In many situations, this isn't even possible. For example, here it's not possible to draw a separating line, no matter how hard we try. But for the time being, we'll assume the classes are separable and deal with the non-separable case later. If we take the generic equation of a line, x2 equals ax1 plus b, the two half spaces it forms corresponds to these inequalities. We want the green points to satisfy one inequality, and the red points to satisfy the other inequality. Then the line will separate the two classes. Each point will give us a constraint we need to satisfy. Since we have 10 points here, we have 10 constraints in total. Now, finding a line that satisfies all of these constraints isn't good enough because it might give us a line that's too close to one of the classes. Intuitively, if we were to classify this new point, we would predict that it's red and not green, so this line is too close to the red points. We ideally want our line to lie somewhere in the middle. To do this, the idea is to add some kind of a buffer and modify our constraints so that our current data doesn't fall inside this buffer. One way of defining this buffer is to vertically shift our line up or down by some amount delta. So the boundary of the buffer is marked by the original line shifted up and down by delta. The inequalities for the green and red areas are also shifted by delta. Because we now have a buffer, we can change our equations to have non-strict inequalities. If we can find A and B, satisfying these new constraints, there will be a buffer of delta to all of our existing points. However, how do we know how large the buffer should be? The trick is we set delta to be a variable alongside A and B, and then set the objective of our optimization problem to maximize delta, so we let the optimization problem find the buffer for us. Let's, however, simplify the notation a bit first. If Pi is a point with coordinates x1i and x2i, then we can write the constraints succinctly like this. When the objective and constraints are linear like it is here, this is called a linear program. A linear programming solver can quickly find the optimal solution. Here, the optimal A is negative 0.18, optimal B is 17.8, and optimal delta is 1.68. Now, let's take the solution and plot the corresponding line. This is the buffer region. The vertical distance of the buffer corresponds to the delta in the solution. So, when the classes are separable, linear programming can return a classifier. Now, let's move on to the case where there isn't a line separating the two classes. Suppose we again consider a line and a buffer. Here, the buffer is a distance of 1 away from the line, but it's a parameter of the model that can be adjusted. We'd ideally like to force the green and red points to be in their own half spaces, but this isn't possible. Therefore, whenever a point lies in the wrong half space or is inside the buffer, we impose a penalty. And this penalty we impose is how much the point has to travel vertically until it clears the buffer and reaches its own region. For a violated red point, the penalty is the distance to the bottom line of the buffer. And for a green point, the penalty is the distance to the top line of the buffer. Of course, if a point is already in the right region, there won't be any penalty. We can write the penalty of any point as the maximum of the distance term in 0. This distance term is going to be negative if the point is already in the right region. Then it's just going to be 0. We can now write the objective as minimizing the sum of these penalties. Now, our objective is not linear in the variables a and b, but as usual, there's a trick we can use. We can introduce a variable ei for each point we have and set this equal to the loss. Then we replace the objective to be the sum of ei. So now the objective is linear, but the constraints are now nonlinear. For the constraints, notice that we can change the equal signs to greater than or equal to, and this is because we're minimizing ei in the objective. This doesn't change the optimal solution. Now, if ei is at least the max of two separate terms, it's greater than or equal to each term individually. This final form is a linear program. If there are n points in our dataset, there will be n plus 2 variables and 2n constraints in our linear program. Solving this linear program returns this line as a solution. And here's the equation of the line. We can use this classifier to predict whether a student would pass or fail. Here's a new set of 20 students from your class who haven't taken the exam yet. And here are their actual results. Our classifier made a few mistakes, but it did reasonably well. That's it for this video. If you liked this and want to learn about another application of linear programming to machine learning, you can check out this other video I have on linear regression. Thanks, I'll see you next time.